and along the coast to Dunkirk. From these beaches in 1940, the greatest and most extraordinary military evacuation in history was brought off.
I found myself walking at the rear of the 4th Division, along the beach with my transport officer. We went round a headland, and there the water was a little bit deeper, and some of the ship's boats were able to get in. But what was happening was that the troops who were perfectly well disciplined, perfectly cheerful, but they were all in subunits. They weren't joined up in their normal battalions. It was rather like a sort of Tottenham football crowd leaving after a successful match against Chelsea or something of that sort. They were all very cheerful. But they were going out to these little boats, and they were scrambling and turning the boats over. So I got my transport officer to stand on the beach, while I went out up to about here, and I shone my torch to him, and every time I shone it, he was to send me out 20 men. And they came out, and then I'd see that they got into the boat one by one, and the boats were not capsized. And then I'd shine this out to sea, and so that all the boats and the ships would come to me. I was a sort of human bridgehead. This went on for an hour and a half, and then I got cramp in my stomach, and I had to come ashore, which was by this time was packed with more troops. However many you got away, there were always more coming. So I said, all my division had gone anyhow, and I couldn't do anything with the others. They had their own officers, and so I set off for Dunkirk. A very wet, a very tired, a rather lonely and a very temporary brigadier, with no troops, no staff, nothing.